You can see it, the passion on stage and off stage, just being with each other, and I'm really gonna miss those people.
I think it has been by far the most enriching part of my chat experience.
The comfort that I feel at school, it's because of the sense of confidence that I've gained from play.
I think because of the standard that it's set to, you feel like you've been a part of something that's so great, so grand, that you feel special being a part of something like that.
Me writing my name on that audition sheet in grade 9 was one of the best decisions I ever made at the school.
They're really gonna stick with me after high school, and it's scary to think that my 4 years at Chat are up and I don't have any more opportunity to be in the play again.
When you walk out onto that stage and see everyone in the audience looking at you, you realize that this is your time and no one can take it away from you.
These people are my family. And I just, that moment when I walk into the rehearsal room and I observe all the chaos around me, and it's amazing. And I love that. I'm gonna miss it so much. Hi, my name is Emma Korber. I am in grade 12, and I've been in the play for 4 years. Okay, so I do this really cheesy thing where whenever I have rehearsals, normally I come a little bit late because my locker's not that close or I want to get a snack. So everybody's already come to the drama studio, but we haven't started rehearsing yet. And in the drama studio, before you start rehearsing, it's chaos. Everybody's talking to everybody because everybody's friends with each other. It's really not that cliquey. People are doing things for their secret friends and singing through songs, and the piano's trying to figure out, you know, what we're gonna play that night. And teachers are conferencing with directors, and people are dancing and singing and doing really weird things and just having fun. I always walk in late, almost always, and I walk in through the door and I take in everything that's going on around me as I like stand by the door. I just like look at everyone, and it like makes me so happy to know that I could go up to any of these groups of people and they would smile at me and include me in whatever they're doing. And these people are my family. And I just, that moment when I walk into the rehearsal room and I observe all the chaos around me, and it's amazing. And I love that. I'm gonna miss it so much. It's hard. I mean, like, you can't say to someone, like, go and put yourself out there, because it's so much easier said than done. But the reality is, for me, writing my name on that audition sheet in grade 9 was one of the best decisions I ever made at this school. The play community becomes your family. They're so here for you, and they're the weirdest group of amazing people you're ever going to meet. I love them to death, all of them, honestly, and it's just an incredible experience. It makes being at school more worthwhile because you have those really fun rehearsals to look forward to at the end of the day for 2 days a week, and play week is everybody's highlight of the year. So if you get the opportunity to immerse yourself in that, then you absolutely should.
I've always been really interested in performing and being on stage and being part of a production. And for me, it's amazing to have the opportunity to find students and my peers who are not in the same grade as me, who all share the same passion and the same love for theater and performing. And the fact that we can put together a pretty high production in such a short amount of time with people of like a large spectrum of new performers, and it's just an incredible experience, and I love it. I would say that I made some of my best friends through the play, because finding other people who share something that you love and you live for is a great foundation for friendships. and I feel like those friends will really stick with me through our entire life endeavors.
Yeah, Elle Matlow was the first friend I ever made in play. We've been best friends ever since. She's one of the greatest people I've ever met. She's so kind and crazy, but she made the chat play experience so memorable for me because she always just taught me to have a good time and that you can laugh at yourself and it's okay to be ridiculous. And we just had a fun time no matter what, if we were in the chorus, if we had the lead. She taught me to stay true to myself.
We've been through a lot together.
sometimes.
We've played opposite each other a bunch of times.
She's hated me. She's loved me.
And it's really fun to be able to have someone who loves something as much as you do.
I think just really the support system and the friendships that you build through play are amazing. Like, there's nothing really else, you know, there's nothing else at school where you can build the same kind of relationship. Like, it's just that kind of extracurricular activity where you're not only with everybody, you know, 2 days a week after school for like 2 hours, but you have that play week part of it. It's just such an amazing bonding experience. There's really not a lot else that's like it. You get to know everyone so well, and you've been through this whole journey, this whole experience together. And I think it's just such a great way to get to know people, and to get to meet people, and it's great for just bringing everybody together.
To me, it means being a part of a family. I mean, when I joined the chat play in grade 9, I really didn't have that many friends yet at chat, and I've made some of my best friends in the school from my experience in the chat play over my 4 years. I think because of the standard that it's set to, you feel like you've been a part of something that's so great and so grand that you feel special being a part of something like that. And I love the reviews that you get every year after the play, and you just have more people coming back every year because they just love being a part of something so special. It just really helps with self-confidence and just gives you so much more respect for the school, and you actually enjoy coming to school because you have something to look forward to. I'm a play kid, and I'm proud to say that I am.
If you have any passion for performing or meeting people or having fun with people who are very outgoing, you have to be the play. I think that I'm going to leave chat, and my fondest memories are going to be the anxiety-provoking rehearsal process or the extremely fun play week, all the pictures that we have, all the videos that we have. They're really going to stick with me after high school, and it's scary to think that my 4 years at chat are up and I don't have any more opportunity to be in the play again.
384 hours. I did the math. Probably incorrectly, because I'm one of those hopeless cases who isn't taking any maths this year, but I did some rough calculations, and I've spent around 384 hours over the last 4 years rehearsing for our school musical. I'll spare you the part where I break that down into minutes, midnights, cups of coffee, inches, miles, laughter, and strife. But I think it's pretty awesome that most of you jungle animals sitting around me caught my rent reference there. And some of you didn't. Well, that's fair, but you're still one of us. We're the freaking play kids. We're the weirdos, we're the misfits, we're the outcasts, we're the overly enthusiastic, underappreciated, attention-craving, dream-filled, incognito rulers of the school. We define what's cool, so maybe Ezra can be a tool. But we still love him because he's just another broken utensil in a shed full of the very same. We build each other up and sometimes bring each other down, but this thing we're able to come together and make happen is magic. 384 hours. I know most of you haven't been along for that ride with me the whole way through, but whether you're happy to hear it or not, I consider you family. Sure, some of you are more like my creepy uncle twice removed, or my pet fish who we thought died a few times but we're pretty sure is still going strong. I won't make this short story long. But I swear, if someone tries to wrong any of you, I'll mess them up. You guys are the chocolate coating to my peanut butter cup. Disclaimer, this poem is not peanut-free. I'm sorry to all those with allergies. Hey, maybe I could borrow your EpiPen for a sec, because my life is being threatened. The end of this week marks the end of an era, so don't be surprised if you see the runny mascara pouring down my cheeks, because these past 4 years, I don't think there's been a week when this crazy, beautiful thing we call play hasn't hovered through my mind. Now I gotta leave it behind. I remember back in grade 9, we were dancing in the halls looking pretty fine, trying to promote a chorus line, and this one kid walks by and yells, "You're gay!" Well, hey. If gay means I'm singing and dancing and eating and laughing till I nearly have a heart attack, with the people I know have always got my back, then I'd take gay any day. But I don't want to start discussing sexuality. I mean, as long as you're a play kid, then you're quite alright with me. You've got so much passion you could make the earth explode, and you've got so much soul that you'd live on right through that self-created apocalypse to put on a one-person show for the stars. 384 hours. The memories are far from sharply carved into my brain by now. Less like a clear-cut photo album and more like a delicious chorus line Mamma Mia hairspray Lion King stew. As you stir the ladle, you pull up a hefty spoonful of one singular sensation. Super trooper lights are gonna find me. Styles keep a-changing, the world's rearranging. Prepared for the chance of a lifetime. Ironic, isn't it? How unprepared I am. Don't try to tell me it's not really goodbye, because I know from experience that the reunions never happen, the Facebook group just becomes a nuisance, and the inside jokes lose their humor. This four-act play has changed my life, but I know the finale is inevitable. I'm anything but ready to let this all go, but I have to tell you, if there's one thing I know, it's that I couldn't have asked for a better group of people with whom I share this show. We're the freaking play kids. We go hard. We're not just aces, we're the whole deck of cards. We're golden, we're bold, the opposite of cold. Our courage and charisma never get old. You've just been told. Who knows what the next chapter is going to unfold? Well, I guess I won't be around to find out. So, before I bid farewell, I'd be honored if you'd join me in raising an imaginary glass. I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to the beautiful harmonies and all those off-key notes. To stomach bugs and sleepless nights, to headaches and sore throats, to Sundays spent at school and to lunches never eaten, to a record for dedication that always goes unbeaten, here's to the 384 hours that have passed, to the incredible and talented play kids who really kick ass. Promised I'm going to keep this thing clean, wouldn't want to ruin the moment with language that's obscene. I'm being told to speed up by the prompter on the screen. Well, as a teacher you might have heard of before often says, a performance is not something you do, but give. And since play has given me so much, and tonight is the last one, it seems that it's time for the torch to be passed on. For now, let's enjoy the time that's left and make this final night ours. I love you guys, and thank you for making this worth those 384 hours.